everyone. I'm Mrs. Carucci, the new principal here at Knollwood School, and I'd like to be the first one to say, welcome back.
Hi, boys and girls. It's Mrs. Stabile, second grade teacher. I hope you enjoyed your summer. I'm looking forward to a great school year. Welcome back.
Hello, boys and girls. I'm Mrs. G. I'm a kindergarten para at Knollwood. I hope everyone is having an amazing summer, and we're looking forward to an awesome year. Welcome back.
Hi, Knollwood family. This is Mr. Axt. I teach third grade. I just want to wish you a warm welcome back to school.
Hi, boys and girls. I'm Mr. Beach. I'm a special education teacher here at Knollwood School, and I get to work with students at every grade level. I hope you had an awesome summer, and I wanted to welcome you back to Knollwood.
Hi, boys and girls. I'm Miss Brennan. I'm a second grade teacher here at Knollwood. I hope you had a fantastic summer, and I look forward to an amazing year together.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Brewer. I'm the school counselor at Knollwood School. Welcome back.
Hey everyone, I am Mrs. Buldo and I am a second grade teacher here at Knollwood School. I hope everyone had a happy and healthy summer. Welcome back.
Alone.
Hi everyone, it's Mrs. Saccone. I am a resource room teacher at Knollwood School and I hope you all had a wonderful summer. Get ready, it's going to be a fantastic school year. Welcome back.
Hi everyone, it's Mrs. Colucci, a first grade teacher at Knollwood School. I hope everyone enjoyed their summer and I'm really excited for a new school year ahead. Welcome back.
Hi everyone, my name is Miss Gobb and I'm the strings teacher at Knollwood. Welcome back.
Hello friends, it's Mrs. Gunlaw from fourth grade. Welcome back.
Hi. I'm Ms. Halbach, the Library Media Specialist at Knollwood School. Welcome back.
Hi, boys and girls. It's Mrs. Holmson. I teach English as a second language, and I work with all the grade levels in Knollwood School. I hope you had an awesome summer, and I'm excited to welcome you back to Knollwood this year.
Hi, students. This is Ms. Iannuzzi. I'm a first grade teacher at Knollwood School. Welcome back.
Hi, everybody. I'm Mrs. Kina, the GROW teacher at Knollwood Elementary School. Welcome back.
Hi, boys and girls. I am Mrs. Lachlan, a paraprofessional at Knollwood School. I'm looking forward to a great school year. Welcome back.
Hi, everyone. It's Mrs. M. I'm a paraprofessional working in Mrs. Tringali's kindergarten class. I hope you all had a great summer and welcome back.
Hi, everyone. This is Ms. Melnick. I'm a fourth grade teacher at Knollwood Elementary School. And I just wanted to say, welcome back. We're going to have a great year. Bye.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Lurie, and I am the reading teacher at our school. I teach grades kindergarten, first, second, third, fourth, and fifth, and I would like to welcome you back.
Hi, my friends. It's Miss Nardiello, your favorite art teacher. I just want to say welcome back, and I'm looking forward to seeing you all back in the art room.
Hello, everyone. This is Mrs. Newman. I'm a paraprofessional, and I just want to say welcome back and have a great school year.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Sullivan, the speech-language pathologist at Knollwood, and I just wanted to say, welcome back.
Hello, everyone. I'm Mrs. Torkery. I'm paraprofessional in Knollwood School. I'm really excited to tell you that. Welcome back.
Hi, boys and girls. My name is Mrs. Sieb, and I teach fifth grade. Welcome back.
Hi, boys and girls. My name is Mrs. Shaw. I am the English as a second language teacher for all K to 5 grade levels, and I just wanted to say, welcome back. Can't wait to have another great school year. Bye.
Hello, boys and girls. It's Mrs. Smith, one of the kindergarten teachers at Knollwood School. I can't wait for this school year, and I can't wait to see you. I just want to say, welcome back.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Snellings. I teach basic skills math across the grade levels and a section of fifth grade accelerated math. Welcome back.
Hey everyone, this is Mr. Supermanian, or Mr. S as most of you know me. I am the physical education teacher here at Knollwood School. Welcome back.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Tringali. I teach kindergarten at Knollwood School. Welcome back.
Hi, it's Mrs. Herrera, paraprofessional at Knollwood School. Welcome back.
Hi, boys and girls. My name is Mrs. Vittorio, and I'm a fifth grade teacher, and I just want to say welcome back.
Hi, guys. It's Miss Walsh. I teach third grade at Knollwood Elementary School.
I just wanted to say I hope you all had an excellent summer and welcome back.
Hi, Knollwood School. My name is Miss Washington. I teach fourth grade and I'm so excited to say welcome back. We're going to have a fantastic year.
Hi, I'm Miss Wrightson. I teach fifth grade at Knollwood School. Welcome back.
Hello, Knollwood community. Thank you very much for taking the opportunity to check out our welcome back video. My name is Ms. Carucci and I'm the new principal here at Knollwood School and I'm excited to be here. I look forward to working together with you to make this school year a successful one for you and your children. The mission of the Parsippany Troy Hills Township School District is to challenge and nurture all students academically, and to develop confident learners who are compassionate, generous, appreciative, and invested in their diverse world. This will be accomplished through innovative opportunities that inspire lifelong learning, critical thinking, and problem solving, creative exploration, and democratic collaboration among students and staff. We look forward to seeing you on the first day of school. We also want to make sure that that first day of school and everyone after is a safe one. We would like to make sure arrival and dismissal is organized for the safety of our students. As most of you are already aware, arrival and dismissal are the busiest times on our school campus. We ask that you support our efforts by adhering to our procedures and safety guidelines, as your child's safety is our number one priority. Student arrival this year is from 8:50 to 8:55. Classroom teachers will greet your child at their homeroom doors at 8:55 a.m. Bus students will report directly to their homerooms upon arrival through the front door, and skip students will report directly to their homerooms from the skip program in the morning. Please review our staggered dismissal times and locations. We will continue with a staggered dismissal this year. Dismissals will occur outdoors, wing one doors, wing two doors, and wing three doors. Please make sure to check where your child is being dropped off during arrival, and then also where they're dismissing. If you do have siblings in the building, we will make sure that the older siblings will report to the younger siblings' location for dismissal. We hope this makes it convenient for parents to find both or all of their children in one location to limit some running around trying to find them. When entering our parking lot, we know that it's very hectic, and we understand that you're trying to get to your children in a fast-paced fashion, but please make sure that if you're using our drop-and-go, you only let your child out of your car at the drop-off location. Please do not let your child exit your car anywhere else where there's moving traffic or anywhere else in our parking lot. It could be extremely dangerous. Our drop-off location is in the front walkway for curbside drop-off. Please take a look at our map, which is coming up next, so that you can get a good idea of how to get in and out of our parking lot safely and efficiently. If you'd like to park and walk your child in, which we do understand, parents can park during at the parking for that is posted in our map next. It's at the front end of the parking lot closest to Knoll Road. There are two rows. We ask that you only use those parking spots, as we don't want any movement within the middle of the parking lot. Can be dangerous to our students. There'll be no through traffic in the center aisle of the parking lot. Once you park, we ask that you walk with your child through the lane and use our walking paths to the school property. There's a walking path on either side of our building. Dismissal. Kindergarten through second grade dismissals, the students must be handed off to a parent and guardian at their dismissal location. Please adhere to the parking lot procedures and safety, just like you did when you dropped them off. When walking through the parking lot to get back to your car with your child, please make sure that they're by your side. Third and fifth grade dismissal, students will be dismissed from their dismissal location. Like I said earlier, we will match them up with their younger siblings to make sure that they're coming out the same door as their younger sibling. Please take some time to look at our map. When entering, either turn down the parking, parent parking aisle, or proceed to the front of the building where you will use our drop-off location. Staff parking is identified. Please don't park there, as our staff needs to get in quickly and efficiently to be able to adhere, be able to attend to the students coming into the building. Walking paths, like I said, are on either side of our building. Please use those. Please refrain from walking through the center of the parking lot as it could be very dangerous to you and your children. When you're leaving our building and you're pulling out of the parking lot, you must turn right onto Knoll Road. This will allow the flow of traffic to continue and prevent any unsafe conditions. Student supplies. Students will need a mask, a backpack that's appropriate for them and their size, a lunchbox filled with healthy and safe food, a water bottle, we do have water filling stations, a smock, which could be a large t-shirt for arts and crafts, a towel so that they can go enjoy some out time during good weather, whether for a math break or for lunch. And any additional school supplies can be found on the school supply list, which is on our Knollwood website. A day in the life of a Knollwood student. This year, breakfast and lunch will be provided for all students in the building. A healthy breakfast will be provided for each student, and they'll be able to eat that in their homeroom. Recess is from 12:05 to 12:35, or lunch, from 12:35 to 1:05. Free lunch will also be provided for all students this year. Students are welcome to bring their own lunch from home, but one will be provided for them. If at any point you determine that you're not interested in receiving the free lunch and or free breakfast, please send an email to me and I will make sure to take care of that for you. When weather permits, students will be brought outside to enjoy lunch. We will also make sure that they get out for mask breaks as well. Throughout the day, students will be receiving their special classes once per day, whether it be music, media, technology, art, or physical education. We have plenty of support staff here at Knollwood, and along with school counselor, we have math basic skills teacher, remedial reading, Title I interventionist, we have GROW and ESL, lots of supports. We have also lots of enrichment and PTA events. When it comes to the health and safety of our students, we rely on our school nurse, Mrs. Alaka, to guide us and to make those decisions and take care of your children when they're not feeling well. She also needs to know, have the records of their physical examinations and their immunization records. If you haven't done that already, Mrs. Alaka will reach out to you to make sure that she has them on file. In Genesis, before we start school, please make sure that you make any updates to your contact information, phone numbers, individuals that might be called if there's an emergency. You can update and change that on Genesis on your parent portal access, especially phone numbers in case we need to get in contact with you. If you're reporting a student absence, enter the absence in Genesis through the parent portal before 9 a.m. in the morning. Regarding your child and whether they will be out because they're ill, please keep your child home when they don't feel well. If you have any concern or question, you can always call the nurse, but they do also need to be fever-free for 24 hours without any medication, bringing that fever down. Regarding food allergies, if your child has a food allergy, please make sure that you let the nurses know. We are not allowed to administer any medication to a child without a doctor's note and documents filled out, so please make sure you take care of that too. And your child's health is very important to us and their safety is very important to us, so we need to keep all lines of communication open to help us help your child. Feel free to call me or Ms. Alaka, the nurse, at any time if you have any questions. Regarding our COVID policy and procedures, these will and could possibly change at any time, so we will continue to communicate with you and provide any updates as soon as they become available. But as of now, as of recording this video, students are required to be wearing a mask. Students and staff will be wearing a mask throughout the day. We'll make sure to provide many mask breaks throughout the day. Students should have a towel with them in their classroom so that we can get them outside to enjoy lunch and have a mask break. This year, we will not be doing individual COVID screening forms every morning through Genesis, but we do please ask that you assess your child's health each morning and keep your child home if they're not feeling well. Students and staff will continue to be reminded of good health safety practices like washing their hands and covering their nose and mouth and keeping a safe social distance. The building will continue to be cleaned and sanitized regularly to make sure that we're following all the procedures necessary to keep both students and staff safe. It is with your help and support that we'll be able to keep our schools open this coming school year. We will also be limiting visitors to Knollwood School and limiting that to scheduled appointments only. If you need to drop off or visit Knollwood, you need to drop anything off, we will have a drop box where we will ask you to call the main office, let them know that you're here to drop something off for your child, or ring the bell to let them know that you're here to drop something off. Let them know what you're dropping off and your child's name, and someone will come out and get the item to deliver it to your child, whether it be a lunch or a book that they forgot, their instrument, paperwork that you need to turn into the building. If you do have a scheduled meeting, we ask that when you come, in order to get into the building, you need to have your license or state-issued identification to enter the building. There is a video next that you can watch to see how to scan your ID. Once you scan your ID and it's done properly, we'll allow you to enter the building and you'll receive a visitor's badge. That visitor's badge will allow you to go to your destination in the building. If you have any questions or concerns that haven't been answered, please, please contact the school. You can call the main office or you can send me an email and I'll be more than willing to speak with you and discuss it and help you the best I can. We hope to have a successful school year this year. I'm here to work with you to help support you and your children. And if you have any questions, please feel free to contact me. Otherwise, what I'd like to say is, welcome back.
So that's what a blue macaw is supposed to look like?
Look at her shining, her feathers they glow. Now the jungle is smiling, 'cause our baby's home. Can you feel what I feel? The day is coming last. Our precious jewel has returned. I'll be the first to say welcome back.
Roberto, I...
Oh, welcome back.
I said a welcome, welcome, welcome.